Smart Grid Technology, organized by Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering, Autonomous Visakhapatnam. A hearty welcome to Dr. A.B. Koteswar Rao, sir, Principal, Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering, Autonomous, Dr. K. Narasimha Rao, sir, Head of the Department, Tripoli, all deans, HODs of various departments, faculties, teaching and non-teaching professionals, research scholars, and the participants from various colleges for this inaugural session. To induce a positive start into the program, I'm starting this with a prayer song. Gayatri Janani Maam Raksha Raksha Garga Muni Sannute Raksha Raksha Devesa Vandite Raksha Raksha Devarshi Samstute Raksha Raksha Vasishta Varadhatri Raksha Raksha Gadhi Nandananute Raksha Raksha Regadhi Vasini Raksha Raksha Vidyarthi Pujite Raksha Raksha Vidyarthi Pujite Raksha Raksha. Thank you. Now I request Dr. Pooja Das Madam, Associate Professor, Tripoli Department, and our Program Coordinator to address the gathering.
A very good morning to all of you who are present in this inaugural our Chief Guest, respected Professor Bidisubuddhi Sir, Professor Electrical Engineering Department, and Dean Research and Development in the IIT Goa, respected President Gayatri Vidya Parishad, Professor P.S. Rao Garu, Vice President Gayatri Vidya Parishad, Sri Dakshinamurthy Garu, Vice President Gayatri Vidya Parishad, Professor K.P.R. Shastri Garu, Secretary Gayatri Vidya Parishad, P. Somaraju Garu, and all respective governing body members of Gayatri Vidya Parishad, our respected Principal of Gayatri Vidya Parishad Autonomous College, Visakhapatnam, Professor A.B. Koteswar Rao Garu, our HOD Tripoli, Professor K. Narasimha Rao Garu, respected all deans of Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering Autonomous, all respected HOD of Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering Autonomous, respected senior professor, advisors, my colleagues, participants, and students. It is an honor and immense pleasure of mine to welcome all of you to the 5 days AICT training and learning Atal Online Faculty Development Program on IoT Interface Smart Grid Technology, IISGT21. Organizing by Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Gayatri Vidya Parishad Autonomous, Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh, India. First of all, I am thankful to AICT Atal for giving this great opportunity for arranging such a quality improvement program in the online platform during this pandemic period. The topic of this today's faculty development program, IoT Interface Smart Grid Technology, clearly indicates the smart implementation of Internet of Things for various applications like synchronization of time, maintaining the system reliability, latency, criticality of data delivery, fast and accurate networking communication in the smart grid environment. I hope this session will help the participants in every aspect, like enriching their knowledge and getting new directions of research in the IoT-based smart grid platform. Our FTP consists of 13 sessions, including 2 lab sessions conducted by VI Solution Bangalore, and 1 session of training of stress management conducting by Sri Vivek Bansal from Rishikesh. Now I am thankful all the participants and congratulating for showing the interest in our FTP and the learning process in Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering Autonomous Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh. I am expressing my sincere thanks and to all the eminent speakers for accepting our request for delivering the lecturers. I'm again welcoming all of you to this 5 days FDP. Now I would like to request our head of the department, Professor K. Narasimha Rao Garu, to give his welcome address. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Pooja. A very good morning and a warm welcome to the Honorable Governing Body members of Gayatri Vidya Parishad, our beloved principal, Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering Autonomous, Professor Dr. A. Balakoteshwara Garu, the program coordinator, Dr. Pooja Das, respected chief guest of the day, Professor B.D. Subudhi Garu, Dean R&D IIT Goa, and all the deans and fellow colleagues and my dear participants. I am delighted to welcome all of you to this inaugural session of ATAL Online 5-Day Strategy Development Program on IoT Interface Smart Grid Technology 21. I am really happy to have received a huge response and enthusiasm by various participants from across the country. On behalf of the department and the institution, I sincerely thank Professor B.D. Subudhi Garu, Dean R&D IIT Goa, for not only accepting to grace this inaugural session as a chief guest, but also to deliver a lecture for one session. This FDP program is especially designed in such a way to meet the requirements of the present emerging areas such as IoT and smart grids. In this context, I would like to appreciate the program coordinator for identifying such a good topic and arranging eminent speakers, both from industry and academia, for all the 13 sessions. I would like to take a moment to share some of the highlights of the department as information to the chief guest and the participants. The Department of Truly was established since the inception of the college in the year 1996. The department offers a BTech program with an intake of 120 students and MTech program in Power System and Control Automation and Power Transmission Drive with an intake of 18 each. Our department was re-accredited for 3 years in 2019 by National Board of Accreditation and also recognized as a research center by the parent university JNTU K Kakinada. Also, our faculty are guiding 5 PhD scholars and 4 more are registered recently from various reputed institutes. Our faculty published 25 plus research papers in various reputed index journals since the last couple of years. Our department is very active in organizing similar FDP, SCTP programs sponsored by the AICTE. For instance, a short-term training program on recent trends in power quality improvement techniques in grid-connected DG systems during 2019. Another 1 week induction bar refresher program on solar PV system design and performance evaluation during June 2018. Apart from this, our department has played a vital role in commissioning of 199 kilowatt wind solar hybrid plant in the premises of 3 Gayatri Vidya Parishad institutions, which was partly sponsored by MNRE. Thanks to Dr. Sastri B. Vedula for coordinating this project. Another AST DST approved R&D project in the area of PED is being worked upon by Dr. G. V. Satish Kumar, Professor. Our department, in collaboration with the Electrical Engineering Department, IIT Bombay, is also working on HBL Power System Hyderabad sponsored R&D project related to electrical vehicle drive system with Dr. Sastri Vividula as the project coordinator. Finally, I would like to conclude by wishing all the participants a great learning experience and hoping they would make the best for this program. Thanks to the program coordinator for giving me this opportunity and a very all the best to all. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Now I request our beloved and dynamic principal of GVP, Dr. ABK Rao sir, to address the gathering.
Thank you, Hema Lalita. Respected Professor P.S. Rao Garu, President Gayatri Vidya Parishad, Professor Subuddhi Garu, Dean R&D IIT Goa, who is kind enough to accept as chief guest for this today's program. Dr. K. Narasimhara Garu, Head of Electrical Department, Dr. Pooja Das, Coordinator of this faculty development program sponsored by AICTE under ATAL, all the heads of the departments, deans and faculty of Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering, and all the participants from different industry or institutes, not only within Andhra Pradesh, from all over the country, more than 200 participants registered, out of whom 30% are only from Andhra Pradesh state, from within our state, whereas the rest 70% are from all over the country, from different parts of the country. My hearty welcome to each and every one of you to this faculty development program. Dear colleagues and respected Professor Subuddhi sir, we believe the strength of any institute depends on the competencies of the faculty members. With this philosophy, we have traveled for more than 25 years and are able to capture good cream of students as their first preference while counseling process for BTech programs in the state. It depends mainly on, as I mentioned, depends mainly on the competencies, not on the buildings or facilities of the institute. AICTE has been bringing in lot many new initiatives and schemes through which faculty are being encouraged to participate in various faculty development programs or short-term training programs. Even during this pandemic, COVID-19, AICTE targeted around 1500 FDPs this year. Previous week, 47 FDPs, faculty development programs, were inaugurated on 2nd August, just exactly 1 week back. Whereas this week, today, 39 FDPs are getting inaugurated with the theme, with the thrust areas such as IoT, artificial intelligence, machine learning, robotics, cyber security, data science, whatnot. All these are very, very topics which are in the need of the hour. Thanks to AICTE for selecting our Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering Autonomous as one of the platforms among the 39 institutes which were selected to conduct the FDP this day, to inaugurate on this day. The theme of this FDP is the need of the hour. Every one of us, being human being, we want smartphones in our hands, facilities, all kinds of facilities with smartness. Even governments identified various cities within our country for their further development to become as smart cities. I don't know with what kind of features the smartness can be brought in into our day-to-day life. To bring in the smartness, sensoring systems, all our students, of course, we also studied sensor systems and feedback and data communicating technology through internet, etc., are the essential parts to bring in the desired smartness so that we can have comfortable living and happy living. Of course, a smart grid very particular to this program, faculty 1 week faculty development program. A smart grid is an electricity network enabling a two-way flow of electricity and data with digital communication technology, enabling to detect, react and proact to changes in usage and multiple issues. Smart grids are expected to have self-healing capabilities and enable electricity users to become active participants. In short, the smart grid shall consist of controls, computers, automation and new technologies and equipment working together hand in hand. And ultimately, the electrical grid shall respond to our, as customers, our quickly changing electric demand. And they should, in fact, they are expected to alarm the individuals, customers. Oh, my dear friend, you are crossing your so-and-so amount. better you switch off so and so, like that also it is expected in near future. And for the successful implementation of these thrust areas into our day-to-day life, knowledge in this regard is expected to be disseminated to the faculty first, and then to the younger generation, that is our students next. And hence the theme by Atal scheme by AICT has sanctioned this program. I think all the participants are aware of all these things. Thanks to all the resource persons, professors from various IITs and NITs and industry personnel who accepted to shower their research findings during this 1 week FDP program. I am once again grateful, sir, Professor Subhudi sir, for your gracing us second time in a different version, in a different manner. Earlier you were gracing us, and now as an expert, I am very confident our participants shall certainly get benefited a lot through your tons of expertise in this field. And my dear all the participants, your attendance means not just the attendance, active participation and performance in a series of quizzes which are conducted after every session and the test will facilitate you to receive certificate directly from AICT. Best wishes to all the participants. Thanks to the coordinator, Dr. Pooja Das, and head of the department for the opportunity given. Once again, sir, I am very much grateful to Professor Subhudi ji. Thank you for your gracing us. Thank you, sir. Thank you, madam.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Now, it's my privilege to introduce Professor P. Srinivas Rao, sir, President, Gayatri Vidya Parishad, formerly Professor of Civil Engineering Department, Dean of Industrial Consultancy, IIT Madras, Dean of Academic Courses, IIT Madras. He acted as first principal of this institution. The institution has molded into this best position due to his visionary thoughts. Because of some pressed and prayer occupation, he could not attend this inaugural function. He asked us to convey this message. I request Dr. Pooja Das Madam to convey the message on behalf of Professor P.S. Rao, sir.
Thank you, madam. A message from the President of Gayatri Vidya Parishad, Professor P.S. Rao, sir. A very warm welcome to all of you to the AICT-sponsored Atal Faculty Development Program on IoT Interface Smart Grid Technology, IISGT 21, being organized by Department of EEE, Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering Autonomous, Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh, India. I congratulate the organizer for arranging this FDP, which has a great contemporary importance for enlightening a different dimension of research in the field of intelligent smart grid technology with the application of Internet of Things. I appreciate the encouragement of AICT Training and Learning Academy Atal for conducting FDP in online mode during this pandemic situation, so that everyone from any part of the country can attain and enrich their learning. I also thank to Professor B.D. Subhudi sir, Dean R&D IIT Goa, for gracing this occasion as the chief guest for the inaugural session. I have noticed active participation from faculty members, research scholars, industry persons from different states of India like Jammu Kashmir, Puducherry, Assam, Kerala, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Odisha, Bihar, Jharkhand, Tamil Nadu, etc., along with Andhra Pradesh. I would like to express my best wishes to all the participants for a great learning and success of the FDP.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for conveying the message on behalf of Professor P.S. Rao, sir. Now I would like to introduce our guest speaker, Professor Vidyadhar Subhudi, sir. Sir has done his Bachelor of Electrical Engineering in NIT Roorkela, M.Tech in IIT Delhi, PhD in Sheffield University, England, and PDF in National University of Singapore. Currently, he serves as a professor, School of Electrical Sciences, and Dean, Research and Development in Indian Institute of Technology, Goa. Prior to this, he worked as a professor in the Department of Electrical Engineering in NIT Roorkela. He served as the head of the department Electrical Engineering and Dean Alumni and Relation and Resource Generation. He also served as a visiting professor at the University of Saskatchewan, Canada, and in Asian Institute of Technology, Bangkok in 2011 and 2013 respectively. He is also a chairman Curriculum and Accreditation Committee. His research areas include system and control theory, system identification and adaptive control, control of photovoltaic system and microgrid, active power filtering, wide area control of power system, control of autonomous underwater vehicles. He collaborates with several foreign universities through international research grants. He has supervised 34 PhD students. His research work was published in 130 reputed international journals and 70 conference papers. He has edited 3 books and contributed 13 book chapters. He is a fellow of Indian National Academy of Engineering, fellow of Institution of Engineering and Technology UK, Newton Fellowship, Royal Academy of Engineering UK, and senior member of IEEE USA. Sir has received Samantha Chandrasekhar Award 2013, Orissa Vignan Academy, Department of Science and Technology, Government of Orissa, and awarded Nitra Research Excellence Award in Electrical Sciences in 2019. Professor Subuddhi Sir has been appointed as Distinguished Speaker by Association for Computing Machinery for the next 3 years. With this introduction, I request Professor Vidyadhar Subuddhi Sir to address the gathering.
Okay, thank you Hema Lalita for introducing me nicely, and I thank the principal of this wonderful institute, Professor K. Koteshwar Rao, and I also thank the head of the department, Professor Narasimha Rao, and Pooja for inviting this FDP program. And I am happy to note that around 200 participants have registered for this program. It indicates a lot of interest has been shown by these participants. So once again, congratulations to the coordinator and this institute for this accomplishment. And I have noted that through the address by the principal that the faculty colleagues of this institute are very much proactive in organizing such wonderful programs. And these are very relevant and upcoming fields where intermittent training and such kind of dissemination will definitely facilitate for further research and further collaborations. So needless to say that the FDPs are very useful to enhance one's know-how. Simultaneously, it should be considered as an avenue to collaborate in several fronts. For example, a joint research, or could be a master degree program, or could be a PhD program that can be planned with a mutual discussion, which is beneficial for all. And this smart grid technology and this IoT, these are not only now the jargons, they become now the reality. So for example, we are always experiencing blackouts in our country or abroad as well. Many times we suffer from this electricity blackout. So the reason is that our grids, current grids, the existing grids are not smart enough. So when we say smart, that means a conventional grid augmented with smart features. For example, it has the kind of good communication, so that we can know the different entities working in the grid to send the information, to have a fault tolerant kind of control, to diagnose the fault where it occurs quickly by using the concept of synchrophasors. And also there could be participation, both the pro-consumer, the producer and consumers, both are linked to the grid through smart metering. And also the communication is very important to prevent the cyber attacks, which is a threat for any power grid, because it is one of the major areas where these research need to be done, so that the cyber attacks could be prevented. So for these, a lot of the smart grid too, as I mentioned, the smart grid facilitates a lot of benefits. For example, it facilitates the integration of the renewables. By that, the carbon footprint will go down. And also the country and all other countries as well, they adopt the electric vehicles. So that means when you adopt electric vehicles, so simply by connecting a grid which is fueled by the fossil fuels, which is energized by the fossil fuel, is not a good option. We could have a grid which should be connected with the renewable energy sources, such that while we are getting the energy from the grid, so simultaneously we will also take care of the pollution. So therefore, one of the advantages of these grids, smart grids, that they facilitate the integration of the renewables. And the other aspects are, it's a dispersed generation, unlike the big power plants where a lot of transmission, distribution, infrastructure is necessary. So small sources could be connected through a small power network. And as a matter of fact, what happens is that you can ensure good quality power, and also the transmission distribution infrastructure can be compensated with. And also if you have a small house, you can have your own power generation. Therefore, you can, whenever there is a requirement is not that important, so you can sell power to the grid and automatically so there is a two-way communication. So the consumer becomes a producer as well. So all these good features, like earlier we are locating a fault takes a lot of time where the power system breakdown occurs, but now because of the PMUs you can locate the faults very quickly, and therefore because of the locating of the faults quickly, you can resume the power without any blackout. And these oscillations, the sustained oscillations, because of the low damping of the power system, is compensated with all these wide area control networks. So therefore, the smart grid is very important, because we are progressing each day towards a better life, a better society. So therefore, smartness in every aspect is more important. And particularly, power is an essential part. So therefore, smart grid is obvious for us. And so having said that, the smart grid is not only a research area for a particular subject. So it is to be contributed by several scientists, engineers, and academicians. So for example, the power system engineers, they have a big role to play. The control, the communication, and the communication, and also the decision making. So, and also the IoT, that means smart sensors, actuators, so many things are important. So therefore, it is a congregation of many research areas. So therefore, very interesting area, of course. I believe that this course has rightly chalked out by the coordinator, so that a variety of aspects of the smart grid, the research area, what is happening elsewhere, and so that will give you a new avenue to pursue your research and to see that what are the technologies available, or maybe what are the journals or what are the research groups they are working on this area. So having said that, I wish that this 5 days course will be very much useful for all of you, and I believe that you will make a good effort towards learning the fundamentals necessary and the research motivation that is essential for contributing to this area. I believe that your participation will be very useful and fruitful. And I once again thank the authorities of this institute, Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering Autonomous, for inviting me to share some of my experiences and to be with you in this inaugural session. And I wish a grand success for this atoll program. And I thank you once again for this wonderful activity. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for discussing the importance of smart grid in our recent life. Now I request Mr. Venkat Rao sir, assistant professor from the department of Tripoli, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Hema madam, for giving me of proposing me to give the vote of thanks. So good morning to one and all. It's my immense pleasure to propose vote of thanks. First of all, my sincerest thanks to the chief guest of today's function, Professor BD Subuddhi sir, Dean R&D IIT Goa, for readily accepting our invitation and sparing his valuable time. My sincere thanks to our president, Professor P. Srinivas Rao garu, Vice President Sri D. Dakshinamurthy garu, Vice President Professor KPR Sastri garu, Secretary Professor P. Somaraj garu, and other governing body members of Gayatri Vidya Parishad for their continuous support in making this Atal FDP program, inaugural session of this Atal FDP program, a grand success. I thank our beloved principal, sir, Dr. ABK Rao garu, for his continuous guidance and support in conduction of this Atal FDP program. I thank our HOD, Professor K. Narasimha Rao garu, and Dean PG and Research, Professor CVK Bhanu garu, and the other advisory committee members for their continuous support and guidance in paving the way to this Atal FDP program and making the inaugural a grand success. I thank all the deans, heads of various departments, senior professors, professors, faculty members, and all the participants in the smooth conduct of today's event. I thank all the staff members who are right behind this event for making this inaugural a grand success. I thank each and every one of them for their kind support and extending their help in making this event a grand success. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. May I request Dr. Pooja Das ma'am to kindly proceed with the further proceedings.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Sir, here we are just completing our inaugural session from Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering. Now I am providing the Google YouTube link of AICT Atal FDP in the chat box for their inaugural session directly from 11. Now you can just proceed, all the participants and the panel members and respective faculty members and professors, those who are interested, they can proceed through the for this Atal FDP inaugural session for all the FDPs starting in the 9th August. YouTube link has been provided. And we are meeting in a technical session one with Professor BD Subuddhi sir at 11:45 in Sarpli in the WebEx session, civil. And I have just shared all the links with the participants. So I'll just, so in this way, I want to conclude this inaugural session and requesting all the participants and the members present in this particular panel to carry forward for the YouTube link of the Atal FDP inaugural session. Thank you all. And welcoming all of you to this 5-day FDP. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Wish you a great success.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Namaste, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Namaste. Yeah.